Amber, Simone, Cotton,
Rouse.
There are so many words I could use to describe you, but in this case, I only need two. The one.
DiAngelo, our wedding day is finally here, and I stand before you today both happy and excited to become your wife. As I look back over the last almost 7 years we have spent together, I can say without doubt or hesitation that I am marrying my best friend.
Someone literally asked me yesterday, how did you know Amber was the one? And my immediate response was, I ain't even gonna lie, bro, I didn't. I wish I could say otherwise, but truthfully, there was a whole lot I still had to learn. For one, I had to learn to listen. I had to learn to read between the lines to understand the differences between what you said and what you meant. I had to learn to be considerate of your feelings, and most importantly, I had to learn to make you a priority.
I'm so thankful to have been blessed enough to find my partner so early in life, a chance that many never experience. There is not a doubt in my mind that we were made for each other, and I am thankful that God allowed our paths to cross. You are more than I ever knew to pray for, and a reflection of God's love for me. I truly believe that we were meant to be together, and God has ordained our union.
So, baby girl, after God, I promise that no one else will come before you. I promise to stock up on eucalyptus spearmint lotion from Bath & Body Works during the annual Christmas sale so that I'm prepared to rub your feet after a long day. I promise to keep pretending not to be interested in YouTube vlogs about makeup and other stuff despite how emotionally invested I may or may not have gotten on the low. Just keep that between us, though. And I vow to protect you and provide for you like your father before me. Lord knows he set a great example. But the Lord also knows he created a monster. Thank you for being my teacher when I needed instruction and my GPS when I needed direction.
You have been there to celebrate with me at my best and support me at my worst. We have grown so much from the beginning of our relationship, and it is amazing to think that we have finally made it to this day. Life has thrown us so many curveballs, taken us through tons of twists and turns, some for better and some for worse. But I wouldn't want to go through this life with anyone other than you. So today I promise to encourage you, trust you, and respect you. I promise to support you in achieving your goals and be a true helpmate to you. I promise to work with you as my life partner, and I believe that together we will build an amazing life better than either of us could have imagined. And although I can't promise that every day will be perfect, as I know that rough times will come, I vow to do my best to make a daily effort to remember why we said I do.
When you say I do, make sure that others don't. For God has joined you together, so make sure that others won't become the reason for discord in your marriage and cause stressful situations. Life's journey alone will have its ups and downs. Invited trouble should not be a destination. Because many will have an opinion on how your marriage is supposed to flow, but the truth of the matter is that marriage takes more than two, you know. It's the bride and the groom to be sure, but it takes the Lord also, while also putting away any negative input to the side. It's trusting and believing in your groom, and the groom trusting and believing in your bride. So this, my children, please do for me. Live, love, and be happy.
The power invested in me and the declaration of your covenant before God and these witnesses. I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
And I'd like to close with an adaptation from one of our favorite movie sagas, Twilight. To quote Bella, if I may, About three things, I was absolutely positive. First, Amber Cotton was a vampire. Second, there was a part of her, and I didn't know how dominant that part might be, that thirsted for my body. And third, I was unconditionally and irrevocably in love with her. Amber, on this day, you've made me the happiest man in the world, and I will always love you. My needs,
according to I've loved you from the beginning, and I will love you until the end, forever and always. You will always remain my best friend, and I can't wait to start this next chapter of our lives and show everyone what we mean by Rouse Rocks the House. I love you.